He finished his race, he won and received his gold, and his race seemed to end so soon after. It started, but that's just the kind of race it was. 10 seconds or less. No doubt, the field felt a lot longer as he was running. He was focusing on his dream, fulfilling a goal and making it happen. The same goal for each of those runners who started. By his sprint to international recognition, he also did something else. He inspired people around the world to do the same, to focus on a dream, to have a goal, and to follow through. A reading from Joel 2 is a prophetic message for those listening who would become fearful of everyday life. Joel's words offer abundance and release and hope.
Hot or cold or too wet or too cold. And all those weather things all
blood that runs his name with Derek Redmond. The great Redmond pulled a muscle, a hamstring, just in the top part of his leg, and he was immediately in pain. He fell down on the track, and he was crying. He was crying. Now, I don't know who won that qualifying race. I don't know who even continued on or who was the oldest in there, whether it was Canadian or not. It was in 1992. I don't know that part of the story at all. All I do know is what happened with that man, Derek Redmond. He was in tears. He was crying. He was in pain. And then he stood up and limped along the track with his name. He was crying along and he was walking very slowly, but his target was still ahead of him. He wanted to finish that race. He was in complete pain. He got up and he walked. And a few minutes later, there was a man that came down from the stands and joined him. People's security were pushing him away to get away from him. He had to leave him alone. He found out that this man had come from the stand with his father. Mr. Redmond had gone beside his son and picked him up, and as his right there in the picture, he's holding him up as his son is crying, and he knows his Olympic dreams are gone. But here, father and son are walking along the lane way on where he's supposed to finish that 400-meter qualifying run. The race is long done by now, but the crowd are cheering. They're on their feet. They're excited. They're watching something that was just unfolding in love before them. Why? Mr. Redmond, Derek Redmond, wanted to finish the race. He wanted to fulfill the goal of being a runner in Olympic history. And the people were applauding and crying and watching as this athlete's dreams ended with an injury. But he needed to cross that line. And he did so with the help of his father. A story of a father and son walking to the finish line, which we remember by many. Paul wrote Timothy two letters, and in the second letter he shares his personal need to accept, accomplish a goal. He has to go home to Rome to face charges. He's traveled extensively all throughout his life, and now he's getting tired, and he's needing to talk to Timothy and write to Timothy and say, don't give up. Keep on going. My time is soon ending. I'm going to be finishing the race that God intended for me. From the moment that Christ talked to me and spoke to me from on the road to Damascus, my life changed forever, and forever I walked and continued to walk for Christ. But the vision I have will stand in completion. He is going to Jerusalem. He's going to be facing the charges as a Roman citizen. Paul's still loving and living for Jesus, but he's now looking forward to the time when he will be rewarded the crown of righteousness once he is in heaven with Christ. He knows that in his human experience in life, he will not be alone, for Jesus will be with him and guiding him along the way no matter what he faces, even as his time on earth. How are we walking the race we call life? What about you? The Spirit is present now, and you've received many blessings of the Spirit which God poured upon you. Just as Joel said, that the Spirit will spend many, many blessings upon the people. They will be blessed. They will have new life. You have received that new life in Jesus Christ. You may not always acknowledge this, these gifts and these blessings, or that the Spirit is alive in you, but as the Spirit moves, you can and will live in Christ. We've been encouraged to pray to Christ because it is not about us, but our need for Jesus in our lives. Through Christ's mercy and hope, we have the opportunity to love others, but we need to keep our focus on Him. We need to seek His mercy and be forgiven through humility and hope. We by Dawn.